Yo, so what's up, everybody? This is me hitting 225 for a very easy single, obviously, just warming up. And after that, I went for a 5-rep max. I went for a new 5-rep max with 265. And unfortunately, I failed my 5th rep, like very, very close. I kept losing tightness in my left lateroid on the bench press, causing for unbalanced reps. I'm not really sure why they kept happening, and as you can see, I just couldn't get it up, so I had my spotter help me, which is okay. So I wanted to do another PR, and I wanted to throw up the, God, these things absolutely look monstrous on me. Like, these things are legit huge. I wanted to do the hundreds and try to hit 5 reps, and you could hypothetically sit there and say that, you know, I hit 6, but the first rep of me getting the weight up, that's pretty much not me at all. It's that voice crack. That's pretty much not me at all. That's 100% like pretty much my spotter helping me up. But 5 reps is technically a PR for me with 100, so I was really happy about that. And my incline dumbbell press strength has been, like, getting really good, and I'm super happy about it. So 5 reps with 100-pound dumbbells is really good on incline to me. Especially, I was using the new incline chair, and I didn't really like it. I felt really unstable on it, and I think it has to do with the cushion. As you can see, this red one that I'm on, my glutes, like, go into, like, the crack where there's no cushion. And it kind of makes you feel more stable in a way. I'm not sure why. But, yeah, that new incline bench I didn't really like. So I went to the old school one, the red one that I'm on right now. Felt much better. And here's me banging out 75s for 3 sets of 12. I only recorded 2 sets because on the second set, my SD card ran out of storage. So I had to delete some videos, but because you're banging out the 75s, and I did a 3x12 with it, and I actually had a 5-rep max schedule and a 4x12, I had a 4x12 after my 5-rep max on bench, but I decided to transition over to incline dumbbell press and make it a 3x12 with the 75s to save more time for hypertrophy, and because I feel like incline dumbbell press has helped my bench tremendously, and I've been focusing on it a lot more. It really does help me out a lot, and I think that you guys, if you really want to, maybe I wouldn't say dumbbell press. I mean, of course, if you want to, you can go ahead, but if you want to get your bench stronger, definitely go on an incline barbell bench, or just do incline dumbbell press, because this shit really helps your flat bench, like, a lot. That's what I've noticed. So, yeah. There's me banging on 75s, and here's me doing some lateral raises. And today I was really feeling it in my delts, and my mid-delt right now is extremely sore. I had to redo my grip right there, because you ever grab a dumbbell and you're just, like, the grip just doesn't feel right, so you kind of have to readjust. It's just what happened there. But I was doing lateral raises today, and I just had this insane mind and muscle connection with my delts, my mid-delt, and it felt really good. Even if it was only just using the 15s, it just felt extremely good. So, yeah. I was just feeling really nice today. Feeling that good mind and muscle connection with my shoulders today, so here's a front angle of lateral raises. Kind of makes me look really ugly. Makes my arms look scrawny. Whatever. Doesn't matter. I was struggling because this shit really burned. So, you know. But you got to do what you got to do to get them big wide delts. So, yeah. Here's me just flexing. Whatever. Showing off the delt pump that I have. My mid delt. My voice keeps cracking, beautiful, but so just showing off literally like the crazy pump that I had in my delt. Okay, here's what I wanted to kind of get at and talk about is these, what I call kneeled down cable tricep pull downs. Now, I kneel on the ground like that. I'm on my knees, basically, and I'm doing the pull down. And this really isolates my tricep and gives me an insane pump using the rope. And I honestly love this exercise so much. It's probably my favorite tricep exercise. What I was doing here is I got on the ground, whatever. I try to keep my elbows somewhat neutral. I start using momentum when I fail, pretty much. But if you want literally the fattest pump you'll ever get in your life and your tricep, do this. Kneel to the ground, put on a heavy weight, and do 10, 8 reps. And when you fail, get up, move it down maybe 30, 40 pounds. Do that until pretty much failure again, and move down 30, 40 pounds again. And literally just basically just keep pushing, you know what I mean? Start using momentum when you fail, and you will literally get the fattest pump ever. Yeah, you will get an insane pump off of doing this, and you can even tell, like, it is not easy, but the rewards for it are so good. My triceps were literally, like, sorry about saying literally so much, but my triceps were so sore after, like, I got done with my push day. They're even so, like, they're insanely sore right now. Like, if I stretch my arm fully, it'll cramp up so bad, so, but, yeah, and I did my set, and I did a few sets after, just keeping the weight around 50 pounds and just going until failure, just to get a, like, nice pump in there, get some blood flow. As you guys know, I have, like, very not good chest genetics when it comes to the underlining of my chest, my overall genetic makeup of my chest. My upper and mid chest looks really good, but if my chest is flexed, my low pec fibers, like, legit disappear, what it feels like, what it looks like. So this exercise really helps me out. I found this out through Athlene X. I'm sure you guys know who Athlene X is. He's a very smart personal trainer, 6 million subscribers, always uploads tips on YouTube. And this exercise, I genuinely felt my low fibers activate, like, extremely well on this. I didn't show my left arm, I just showed the right arm because I wasn't going to move the camera, kind of didn't really feel like it. So next set, here we go. I did 3 sets, didn't record all 3 though, and on each arm. This genuinely activated my low pecs very good. Like, I was very surprised. I felt them activate. I even felt a little bit of a pump in there. And that's very good because my low pec fibers are just the worst. They're the worst. Like, my chest isn't flexed, it looks completely normal. Like, actually really good, actually. But if I flex, you know, the lower pecs are just not treating me good. So this exercise is really helpful if you need lower chest development. It'll really hit those low fibers and give you that under swoop, underlining, whatever you want to call it. So that's a very good exercise. And I'm definitely going to incorporate that literally, like, every day I do a push day. Here's me just doing some dips. I didn't record all the sets. I did 3x10 on it, just using my body weight, no weight. I do have a dip belt, but I didn't use weight because I feel like it would kind of take time, and at this point, it was about 8:40, only had 20 minutes left, so I didn't really want to do it with weight. Just wanted to use my body weight, slow control the reps, and they felt really good. You know, nothing special about dips, really, just body weight exercise that usually people who are lighter are good at. Like, and here's a older man, about maybe 76 years old, benching, and I loved it. I recorded it because it's actually so awesome to see him do that when he's so old, but, It's just sweet. Like, it's so motivating, so inspiring to see someone do that. But, yeah, pretty much that was my push day. Pretty simple. Didn't record everything, but, it was a good push day. And here's flexing footage.
Yo, so what's up, everybody? So right now it is currently Saturday. Dylan's about to come over. You guys have seen Dylan, and if you saw my 4-day eating vlog, he's my best friend, one of my best friends. Anyway, so I had a push day today, and I failed 305 on bench press when my 300, if you saw my 300 round bench press, it was so easy. And I failed 305 today because I'm pretty sure between me and you, I woke up on 7 hours of sleep, really good optimal sleep. 7 hours is always great. And I had morning wood, you know what I'm saying? Kind of just boom and beat it up, you know what I'm saying? And then I passed out again until 4 o'clock, like on 11 hours of sleep or some shit like that. The gym closes at 6. I usually work out for about 2 hours. My dad goes to my room, he's like, yo, we're gonna go to the gym, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, what do you mean? He's like, it's Saturday. I'm like, fuck. So I overslept. I released all the shit from my body on a test. And yeah, I passed out. It was horrible. And so I go to the gym like at 4:40, not nearly enough time as I usually would want. I go on bench. I have a swimmer max scheduled. I ate pretty good the day before. And boom, I fucking failed it. And I'll show you here. Yeah, that was me failing the 305. Fucking sucks. But next time I'm not gonna do what I did. And yeah, so I'm not gonna do that again. And I'm gonna hit it next time when I have a warm max, maybe 310, who knows. A lot of you have been asking also, why do you bench 2 times a week on David's program when there's OHP on it, and then bench, like, you know, once a week? I want to hit a 315 bench, and then I want to translate into OHP again, because I feel like my main focus right now is 315 bench. It's kind of like what I'm like really want to do. And yeah, so if this is going as planned, you just saw hopefully a good voiceover of my push day, my last push day, not this today, but my last push day. You saw a good voiceover, just whatever, talking to you guys. And I asked on Instagram what you guys want to see. You guys want to torture me, and you guys want me to do 100 rep squat challenge, and you guys know I got the monster quads, so I got the Tom Platz quads, so I'm gonna fucking do it. I'm gonna do it, 100 rep squat challenge. I'm gonna go in for it, fuck it. On Monday, I'm pretty sure. Tomorrow's Sunday, I can't go because the gym closes at like 3 o'clock. I'm a teenager, I don't wake up in time. I wouldn't wake up at 1 because my sleeping schedule is literally fucked. I'm gonna go on Monday. I'm gonna record a 100 rep squat challenge. I'm gonna want to dive, that's perfectly fine. I'm ready for it. And I'm also gonna throw in some foods right now. So it's post-workout, just got home. I'm going to devour this French toast, homemade, so good, like amazing. I cannot express, this is my favorite food on the entire planet, is homemade French toast. Just take a moment, just look at that. Just check it. That looks so good. But yeah, so I'm gonna devour this French toast post-workout. I'm gonna make a 2-scoop protein shake of pure True Mass. It's gonna be 1,400 calories and 96 grams of protein. I don't know how many calories that is. I assume a little bit under 1,000. So I'm gonna hypothetically say I'm sitting around 2,400 calories right now. And yeah, that's pretty good. I need my maintenance for me. I need to eat a little bit, like I'd say like 1,000, 2,000 more, anywhere over 3,000 calories. So I'm already 2,400 after I make my protein shake and eat this. So I'll show you what I eat some later time today. But yeah, for now, I'm gonna make this protein shake. I'm gonna eat this and get a quick 2,400 calories in pretty much. And yeah.
Nice. Start off with a strong zero by Mr. Dylan A. All right, we got DG and L. We got Dylan, Daddy, and L Dog, so. I've literally never seen someone be so prepared to match for a bowling game. Okay, we fucked up, we gotta restart the game, and Dylan gets 2 gutter balls, and we restart, and he gets a fucking strike, so that's fair.
Hey, what can I say, man?
Any opinions on that one?
Interesting, I was looking at my phone, I didn't hear any pins get knocked over.
Oh, my back is so small. Ooh, I can't bowl.
Yeah, you hit more than Colin on your first roll.
My rotator cuff's torn. He's being Colin arm muscle. Ooh, look how small my muscles are. Ooh.
All right.
and Dylan are the only ones with strikes right now, and Colin doesn't know how to play, how to bowl. Yeah.
My name is Dylan A.
Yo, he just got absolutely demolished, bro. Ah! It's all luck for real. What is that?
What am I supposed to see? Huh?
Ice in my veins.
I got weighted pins.
Might be back in the game.
That's two in a row.
You might be back in the game.
That's two in a row.
I'm just saying.
It's two in a row.
Uh-oh.
Put on me.
Imagine if he got the turkey, it would have been absolutely dirty. Dirty shorts.
Dang, 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 dang.
I'm winning.
Dylan, you still got another turn, buddy.
All right, go hit that shit, bro.
Got you.
Hey, man. It's gonna gutter. What the fuck did I say?
Oh my god, Dylan's horrible today, dude.
Y'all cheating me, bro.
Dylan's actually getting demolished. Oh my god, he's doing horrible. I'm gonna come.
Game time to that. As C Rude, he's still got one more roll.
Absolute game changer that, as Colin Rude knocks down the spare. Really puts the pressure on Lex Little. Alright, here we go with his last attempt. Knocks down about 7 there. We'll see. Ends with a 115. Looks like Lex is really gonna have to go all out here if he wants to get the win. Here we go. Lex trying to take the victory.
Sight!
Do it! Do it!
Knocks down 7 there. If he needs, the only chance he can win here if he comes out with a spare. The crowd is going absolutely nuts right now.
Joke.
And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Colin wins.
This next man goes like this, taking up on my elbow where he goes, I'm sizing you up.
When did you do that?
Yep. Yeah. Go ahead.
Mmm.